Hello, welcome. Yes, I am again with you with a new case of duality in linear programming problem. The case is maximize z equals to 3x1 plus 5x2 plus 7x3 subject to the constraint x1 plus x2 plus 3x2 less than or equal to 10 and 4x1 minus x2 plus 2x3 greater than or equal to 15. x1 and x2 are non-negative and x3 is unrestricted in sign. Our objective is maximization, so the sign of all the constraints should be less than or equal to, but in the second case that is not, so we have to revise the sign. It will be now minus 4x1 plus x2 minus 2x3 less than or equal to minus 15. So now we have all the two, first and second, constraints with less than or equal to sign in matching with the objective. Another problem is x3 is unrestricted in sign. We cannot solve a linear programming problem, or we cannot construct a dual of a linear programming problem till we have any decision variable unrestricted in sign. To solve an LPP or to write a dual of an LPP, all the variables should be non-negative. So first we have to consider that matter in case of x3. And what is the way out? We should take x3, the unrestricted variable, as difference of two non-negative variables. Let x3 be the difference of x4 and x5 such that x4 and x5 are non-negative. That is, x4, x5 both are non-negative. But because of this, we have to rewrite the primal. We will consider the effect of both the changes, this one and this one. Maximize. Okay, let us simplify the thing. What is going to happen exactly? See, x3 equals to x4 minus x5. We have x3 at three places, in objective function, in constraint 1, in constraint 2, with different coefficients. First is 7x3 in the objective function. What will happen? That will be 7 into x4 minus x5. So ultimately it will be 7x4 minus 7x5. Similarly, in case of first constraint, that is as 3x3. That will be 3 into x4 minus x5. So it will be 3x4 minus 3x5. And similarly, in the second constraint, it is minus 2x3. Minus 2x3. Be careful, there is negative sign. Minus 2 into x4 minus x5, that will be minus 2x4, not minus x4, but minus 2x4, and minus into minus plus 2x5. See, the sign of two variables representing one unrestricted variable is always opposite to each other and the coefficients are always same. Now, what is going to happen? Primal, that is revised. That will be maximize z equals to 3x1 plus 5x2, and in the place of 7x3, now that will be plus 7x4 minus 7x5. Subject to, first is x1 plus x2, and now 3x3 is there, but at its place it will be 3x4 minus 3x5. And in the second case, minus 4x1 plus x2, in the place of minus 2x3, that will be minus 2x4 plus 2x5. Yes, less than or equal to 10 in the first case and less than or equal to minus 15 in the second case. Now we have four variables, x1, x2, x3 and x4, all are non-negative. Now, the sign of all the two constraints are less than or equal to, matching with the objective, and all four decision variables are non-negative. Now we can write the dual of this revised primal. First of all, we have to write the dual of the revised primal. Against maximize, the objective must be minimized. Z star will be, let us do our working note to make it simplify, y1, y2, and this will be our coefficients in Z star. Yes, okay. Now Z star will be 10 into y1 and minus 15 into y2. Since we have only two constraints in the primal, we will have only two variables in the dual. Subject 2. Yes. Now, from x1 first constraint, from x2 second, from x4 third, from x4 fifth. We will have 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 constraints. y1 minus 4y2 greater than or equal to 3. Now from here, y1 plus y2 greater than or equal to 5. Now it is turn of x4. 3y1 minus 2y2 greater than or equal to positive 7. Now it is turn of x5. Minus 3y1 plus 2y2 greater than or equal to minus 7. Okay, now the original dual has three variables, original primal has three decision variables, so our final dual must have only three constraints. But this dual has four constraints. Why and what to do? See the last two constraints. They are similar to each other, but the difference is of sign. 3, minus 3, minus 2, 2, 7, minus 7. Remember the previous case? These two constraints represent an equality. So, after removing these two constraints, in their place, we have to write one equality with the sign of the first constraint. Why so? See, the third variable in the original primal is unrestricted. And where there is unrestricted variable in primal, there must be an equality in the dual. Not only that, since our third decision variable in the primal is unrestricted, our third constraint in the dual must be equality. So, these two represents equality. Yes, sorry. Y1 and Y2 both are non-negative. Now, our dual that will be treated as our final dual of the original primal, that will be minimized. Z star or ZY equals to 10Y1 minus 15Y2 subject to, the first will be as it is, Y1 minus 4Y2 greater than or equal to 3. Second will be as it is, Y1 plus Y2 greater than or equal to 5. But in the place of third and fourth, only one will be there, 3Y1 minus 2Y2 equals to 7, and y1 and y2 both are non-negative. Now we can tell you all the things against maximization, minimization. Two main constraints in the original primal, only two variables in the dual. There are three variables in the primal, there are three constraints in the dual. Third variable in the primal was unrestricted. Third constraint in the dual is equality. So this is the final dual of the original primer. That's it. Thank you very much.